As it was described for alkali metals of group 1, it is possible to observe emission spectra, and therefore we can use flame tests as qualitative tests to identify the elements of group 2 for their characteristic color in the flame. The test is only possible for calcium, strontium and barium, because beryllium and magnesium emit radiation that don't fall in the visible region of the spectrum. The explanation of this color is the same we have discussed previously with alkali metal, that is, the metal atom absorbs thermal energy from the flame, and in some atoms get excited because some balanced electron jumps to a higher energy orbital. This is an unstable state, and when the electron eventually comes back to the ground state, giving back the thermal energy, most in the form of the radiation. In the case of alkaline earth metals, the color emit is so colorful that certain alkaline earth metals are used in firework display. Here we are going to visualize that color in a small scale through the colors emitted when a set of compounds containing the metal ion are heated in the flame. Again, we are going to use our spatula pinned to a piece of cork, and we will rinse it in water between each experiment in order to avoid any contamination. The first metal we are going to see is calcium. Employing calcium dichloride, this compound emits an orange-colored flame that corresponds to a wavelength around 620 nanometers. Let's continue with strontium, and we can see the color is crimson, corresponding to a short wavelength around 460 nanometers. Finally, we are going to check the color for the same barium salt. In this case, as you can see, we have a beautiful green color for a wavelength around 550 nanometers.